rolling the stone. We began here, the place, heaven, the time about 2 days ago. Oh, let me clarify. 1,000 years on earth is for a day in heaven, and a day in heaven is as 1,000 years on earth. So, about 2,000 years ago, earth time, or 2 days ago, in God's time, things in heaven were especially lively. Can you hear the sounds of worship? The angels, the creatures, the saints, the elders, and all the other heavenly beings amped up their worship because Jesus, in his death and resurrection, had just reconciled humanity to himself. But what is less than a second in heaven was a long 3 days from the time of Jesus' death to where we are now. Heaven's rejoicing is like never before. But those who loved and followed Jesus are in mourning. For the moment, hope is lost. They need a sign to let them know not only that Jesus is more than all right, but that they are more than all right too. Let's gaze in on how heaven responded.
Thank you.
to three. Have you ever wondered what went through the minds of the two men crucified with Jesus? While we hear from the repentant thief, our focus remains on the center cross, the source of his hope and ours.
Well, I proved them right, and I hope they're satisfied. Why should I care anyway? Nobody ever cared for me, that's for sure. Get them before they get me, that's what I always said. And I got them good. I got them real good. Nothing mattered. Least of all, those religious hypocrites with their fancy robes and high and mighty ways. Oh, they sounded fine, but they didn't care if I lived or died. And now they stand there gawking, just waiting for me to die. I wanted to spit in their faces and yell, "You did this to me." People like me don't stand a chance. I bet that guy on the third cross knows what I'm talking about. He's been yelling and cussing all day. Funny thing, though, most of it's been at that man on the middle cross. There's some kind of sign over the middle guy's head, and everybody keeps calling him the King of the Jews. They yelled at him to save himself if he was the Son of God. What's this Son of God stuff? Didn't seem like much of a king to me hanging on a cross, so I gave him a mouthful too. But I've never seen anybody act like him. He didn't cuss or yell. He didn't fight back. And he kept saying stuff that didn't make a bit of sense. Stuff about forgiveness and people not knowing what they were doing. Seemed to me they knew exactly what they were doing. They were killing us and laughing while they did it. But the more I watched and listened, the more I wanted what he had. He was dying just like us. I don't know how to explain it. He seemed peaceful. Man, if he could be peaceful hanging on a cross, what's going on? So I kept listening, and the more everyone made fun of him and said he wasn't God's son, the more convinced I became that he actually was God's son. So I told the other guy to shut up. The two of us knew we'd end up here someday, but this man didn't deserve it. And then I asked the man, Jesus, to remember me, and he told me he would. For the first time in my life, somebody promised something I could believe. He said I'd be with him in paradise today. Paradise? Can you believe it? For a bum like me? Just doesn't make sense, but I don't care. I trust Jesus with this worthless life. What little I have left.
Shalom. Fish. Good day to you. Could I interest you in a mess of fish? I just caught them myself this morning. Well, if you're hungry later, we'll be here. Just in case you are still hungry. Unless we're so loud of them.
You would think with all the festivities going on, business would be better.
Ah, no need to despair. The day is young. Say, have you heard the latest about Andrew and Peter?
What about?
They left their fishing to go follow that teacher named Jesus. You know, the one that they crucified a few days ago?
I heard. At first, I thought they were surely out of their mind and losing their mind. I mean, why would you give up a good job, even if it required hard work? You know, and wander around with someone who has no apparent means of support. But it wasn't just Peter and Andrew. It was Zebedee's two boys, James and John. They quit everything and left too. They say they're now fishers of men.
Now that is strange. Very strange.
That's what I thought. But at first, until I heard him teach. Did you ever get a chance to hear him teach?
No, I can't say that I did. Not that I was really interested anyway. Why do I ask?
Well, I don't know if I can explain it, but there was something different about him. I mean, he showed compassion to everyone and love to everyone. Even the bums, the crazies, the down and outers, he showed love to them. And it was just really amazing. And his teaching wasn't so much as rules and traditions, but he talked more about a relationship with God and others. And it was just really a blessing that he shared that. You know, then it was like the religious leaders had some concerns with that because they had their do's and don't lists, you know, which helps them to justify their purposes.
Uh-huh.
And even when they arrested him and beat him, he still didn't fight back. I just didn't understand why they crucified him. The examples that he set and the way that he lived was truly a blessing for us. But who am I? I'm just a fisherman. You know, I really wish someone with a life that was good as his wouldn't have lost it as easy as he did.
You know, there's a rumor going around that he arose from the dead.
Really? I stayed out fishing a little longer than I normally would, usually, so I hadn't talked to anyone since the day he died. I wouldn't be surprised, though. As I told you earlier, it was something about him. He was special.
Oh. Fine day, isn't it, friend? Could I interest you in a mess of fish? Just holding myself this
fish. Way. Fish! Fish!
Well, hello there. Is this your first trip to Jerusalem? I've lost count of the number of times we've come. We try to make it for Passover every year. The travel time helps us to catch up with the lives of our family and friends. I remember well the year Joseph and Mary's boy was 12. Always such a responsible young fella. His behavior that year seemed especially strange. Well, we had a fairly routine trip here, but let me tell you, our return home was anything but ordinary. After a full day's journey, Joseph and Mary couldn't find Jesus. They checked with everyone in our group, but no one had seen him all day. Forgetting their fatigue, they immediately started backtracking. 3 long days later, they finally found him. He had been with the teachers in the temple courts the entire time, listening, asking questions, and amazing everyone with his understanding. Of course, Joseph and Mary's ability to appreciate his maturity was a bit hampered at that point. Until then, though, I can't recall a single time Jesus' family questioned his behavior. When his parents told him to do something, he did it. If they told him not to do something, he didn't. He always requested permission for special activities. He tried not to offend the other boys, but at the same time, he had no qualms about standing up for what was right. I still wonder why a little of his actions couldn't have rubbed off on my boys. Anyway, back to the story. Jesus, puzzled at his parents' search, asked if they didn't realize he would be in his Father's house. I doubt that anyone fully grasped the significance of that question at the time. However, all that and more made perfect sense now. His life, his obedience, and his ministry of the last 3 years, everything began to fall into place. Jesus, my young neighbor, my children's playmate. I can't believe it. He's our Messiah. Even harder to comprehend, however, is his recent mockery of a trial. I can't find any logical reason for such a miscarriage of justice. And then his cruel, senseless death. I might have believed it for someone else, but not for Jesus. Never Jesus. But you know, his tormentor's victory, however, was short-lived. 3 days after his crucifixion, Jesus burst out that tomb wide open, and out he came. Hey, ask around. Everybody's talking about it. Some in whispers, others openly. But me? I'm ready to shout it from the rooftops. I know. I get a little carried away, don't I? I hope I haven't delayed you too long. But I just can't keep this good news to myself. Enjoy the rest of your journey. Shalom. Go in God's peace.